Welcome to the Linux Gaming News Punch episode 16, your weekly roundup to help you keep up to date. This week we learned that the Bard's Tale Barrows Deep is finally going to get Linux support, although they're still being a bit vague about it. They said it's coming with the big Director's Cut upgrade, which is launching, and they said sometime this summer. That's good, and I'm glad for those who did support it on Kickstarter will finally get their hands on it. However, there is a bit of bad news that came along with it as well. They've mentioned that the revamped Bard's Tale trilogy is not getting Linux support, and they directly mentioned Steam Play as a reason why. As they said, Mac gamers have been unable to play it, whereas on Linux we've got Steam Play. I should note though that the Bard's Tale trilogy was never actually confirmed for Linux in the first place anyway, so it's not like we're losing something that was actually confirmed, just to make that clear. However, some may see this as confirmation of their feelings about Steam Play stopping Linux ports coming, and I can certainly see why they might feel that, since Steam Play was mentioned as a reason for Linux not getting the Bard's Tale trilogy. Either way though, the Bard's Tale Barrows Deep is coming. It'll be this summer with the Director's Cut upgrade. Now for a little bit of open source gaming news, and for those who are a big fan of real-time strategy games like me, OpenRA for playing classic Command & Conquer titles is getting another major update soon. This will finally enable saving your single-player campaign and skirmish matches, so you don't need to blast through every mission in one go. It's also seeing some big interface improvements, like with the original Command & Conquer game. When you play it through OpenRA, it just has a very generic sidebar, which is now going to be styled properly for Command & Conquer. I have to say, I'm absolutely amazed at OpenRA. It works beautifully well, and since both Command & Conquer and the original Red Alert are games from my childhood, I'm so happy to be able to play them with a modern and open source game engine on Linux. And it does feel like a more modern game as well. It's great. We also have some more information on Google Stadia, their game streaming service, which is powered by Linux and Vulkan, specifically Debian Linux. From what they've said, it's going to have two tiers. There's a basic tier that you'll get 60 frames a second, but it's locked to 1080p resolution, and you'll be buying games as if you would be on Steam. Then they have the Stadia Pro subscription, which will be about $9.99 or £8.99 a month, which allows 4K resolution. You get some free games bundled with it now and then, surround sound support, and exclusive discounts. From what I hear coming out of E3 just recently as well, publishers might even have their own extra subscription on top of Stadia Pro, where you might get access to their full library of games. That could be quite interesting. However, only people who buy their limited Founders Edition get access in November this year, and it's quite costly, over £100. But it does come with the Stadia controller and a Chromecast Ultra, so might be reasonable. I'm not really sold on game streaming myself yet, but I will give it a go to see what I think at the wider release. As long as they truly stick to their aim of letting people play anywhere, then it's certainly going to be interesting, and it does lower the barrier for Linux gaming again, since you only need a web browser. One thing that I mentioned before on the website gamingonlinux.com is that this could help Linux adoption, because think about it, to play games on Stadia, all you really need is a really low powered Linux box, and you can play AAA games, essentially. There would be no need to buy a Windows license or anything like that. So it could help, it might not, but it's powered by Linux, it uses Vulkan, so hopefully that means there'll be a lot more developers out there using Vulkan, which does lower the barrier to doing an actual proper Linux port. And now for a quick one about Steam, because the Steam pipes are once again leaking, as Valve had a download up of files for Steam's new library overhaul. This was sent out on Twitter by Steam Database. I've now tested it, and I do have to say, it looks pretty swish. It is a big improvement on the old stale Steam library interface that we have now, which has largely been untouched for quite some time. It makes it easier to find games you want and add them to collections, but it does have some rough edges, obviously, because this is a leak, it's not final. Now for one for the space nerds like me, Bugbyte have released the second alpha version of their spaceship colony building sim, Space Haven. They provided me with an early key to test, and honestly, I've been having so much fun with it, time just absolutely flies by, it's ridiculous. It's quite unique as well, since most colony building sims have you on some sort of set location, whereas Space Haven because you house your people on spaceships that you continually expand and travel with. And the latest version lets you build multiple ships, which is pretty damn cool. Another reason Space Haven is quite sweet is that you get to directly control your people. You can draft them into your service, and then you get to send them on boarding parties to various ships to take down some nasty aliens or salvage a derelict ship. It's pretty cool. Quite excited about this one, as it has a really cool style to it. Now onto a game called It Lurks Below. It's a 2D survival RPG from David Brevik of Greybeard Games. It's now been confirmed for Linux. For those who don't recognize the name, Brevik is one of the original Blizzard North founders who made Diablo and Diablo 2, so I'm pretty keen to see what they've made as an indie. I personally spoke to Brevik, who told me, and I quote, "Yes, I am working on a Linux version. I hope to release it in the next few weeks, depending on how many bugs the release has." So that's great, but with that in mind, it did only leave early access at the end of May, so it may have a few rough edges to sort out first. Like they said, they'll wait and see how the release is. To get a sense of what It Lurks Below is like though, think about Terraria, only RPG style with character classes. It looks pretty good though. For those who are a fan of real-time strategy games like me, I've got a good one here for you. It's called The Fertile Crescent, and it's available free on itch.io. It's a bit like a streamlined indie version of Age of Empires. And while it is early days yet for the Fertile Crescent, it comes already complete with solo play versus a rudimentary AI, and it does have online play so you can take on your friends as well. The latest update actually makes the Linux version run really nicely too, so it's good to see it getting some attention. Interestingly, they've also added in their own version of a guard tower, but it doesn't fire by itself. It's not like a traditional guard tower. You actually have to garrison some units in it for them to get extra range. It's an interesting way of doing it. And honestly, it's surprisingly good for something so early in development. Finally, here's a bit of a quirky one for you. It's called Industrial Petting, and it reminds me somewhat of Slime Rancher. In Industrial Petting, you, and possibly friends, as you can play online, are tasked with looking after strange alien creatures, making them happy, and then selling them on for a profit. However, you'll be automating this process somewhat with weird machines, like an automated petting machine. Sounds hilarious, to be honest. I asked the developer of Industrial Petting about Linux support on Steam, and they said, and I quote, "Yep, getting a Linux release and currently have Linux testers on Ubuntu." So that's another one confirmed for you. And that's all for this week. Thank you again for joining me and for listening. I will be here around the same sort of time next week. Until then, make sure you visit gamingonlinux.com for your daily info. Thank you, and see you again soon.